Hey, welcome everyone. As promised in the group, I will show you what the repair of a Mercedes door sill looked like. It looked exactly like this. In addition to filling in the gap with a few inserts to form the final shape, there were also repairs. There were holes from the list plugs to be closed because the client wanted everything to be smooth. Well, but let's get to the core of the matter, which is the new adhesive from the company Ataszek, which currently looks like this. There are an incredible number of changes, all positive. Let's start with the fact that the filler is cut into short sections, approximately 20 centimeters. It makes the process incredibly easier when it comes to welding, because you don't have to drag along the entire string or simply cut individual pieces of such a bonding material to use it. You simply pull out one such strip. I don't know if I can do it now with one hand. Sure. Oh, it looks like this. And generally, we weld with it so well, everything, melts and fits into the welding machine's holder that you can really use such a, rod down to the last millimeter, right? For welding, we use this hot iron welder. I have the American version, which works perfectly for this. And why is that? Because the hole in this footpiece has a diameter of approximately 3.13 millimeters. And the solder, as you can see, which has been successfully improved, has a diameter of 3 millimeters along its entire length and maintains a length of 3 millimeters everywhere. Sorry, not length, but diameter of 3 millimeters. So it fits perfectly into the hole of the foot. The melting process is smooth, continuous. There is no need to force this filler material. If the diameter were larger, it doesn't melt well. If the diameter were smaller, it's just that this diameter is perfectly maintained, probably with an accuracy of 1/10 of a millimeter, because there are really no thickenings, no thin areas on it. Really excellent solder from this perspective. Another plus, it melts beautifully. As you can see here, the color is yellow, yellowish transparent. Don't look at this area because it's an old place, after which there was fiberglass, so it degraded this plastic probably from the chemistry of the fiber. From the chemistry of the resin, sorry. But as you can see, the adhesive applies very nicely. It spreads very nicely. We are using a temperature close to the temperature we used in previous versions of this material. That's about 320, 330 degrees on the base. The material also, works beautifully for us, really. I use this type of belt sander for working, after which I finish everything with an oscillating sander, a Bosch one. And the general effect is such, as you can see here, or maybe not, because it really turned out very, very well. Under the finger, you practically can't feel any step. The surface is completely smooth after passing. So if you have quite good processing equipment, you can achieve an almost smooth joint with this material. Well, what else can I add about this filler? Well, nothing really, just that you can safely, with peace of mind, purchase it. It will work excellently for welding PUR. it is much stiffer compared to previous generations. It processes very nicely, as I already mentioned. Well, well, you can't really expect anything more from such a bonding agent. And it will definitely work with all types of materials, like PUR, that is with some GF or MF. This is already a tested mixture by me on at least two or three elements, and everywhere the durability properties are just amazing. So I really highly recommend it, and see you and hear you in the next videos.